Hello everyone, this is the last video in a series of Love Summer Art, and I'm combining it with the challenge that I'm working on, the iCAD challenge, because I'm way behind because of this Love Summer Art thing, and so I'm going to combine them. These are the stamps, the new stamps from Art Jenny. They were released 2 days ago, 3 days ago, and I was desperate to work with them, so I already stamped them on this page. And when I was working on it today, I thought, oh, I'm gonna use them. So I'm coloring them with a marker, fine tip marker, and a water color pencil. I did the on the other houses the same way, so I'm not gonna bother you with that. Now, the prompt today was use gesso. So I've stamped several of those beach stamps with gesso to create a nice background. And here are the houses again. I'm just fussy cutting everything, and I really didn't want to color these shells individually, so I thought I'm just going to scratch with watercolor pencil on my paper and then just use a water brush to color it in. Easy and very quick. And you get a nice color variation. Go in with a yellow pencil here and there. And then I fussy cut it some of them. Then I wanted to create a beach scene, well, a sunset really. I messed up here because I started way too dark with the dried marigold. I thought I need to save it, so I'm going to go in with Stormy Sky and Tumbled Glass later, but it just went green. Of course it went green. Yellow and blue makes green. So I was thinking on how to save it because I really love that gesso background. So I thought I'm going in with Mustard Seed to lighten it all up around the sun, but it only made it worse. It went greener. And while I was doing this, I was thinking, okay, this doesn't work, so I have to do something with the fussy cutted pieces to cover up this sun. And then I thought, okay, I might just make it even worse by using a bit of water to let it blend a bit. Didn't work, as you can see. So I thought I'm going to go in and do it and make a really round sun in the middle of it. And then I thought, okay, I can work with that. That's how it goes. And then just blend it out to the sides just a little bit. And I thought, okay, I still need a cover up, but not the entire image. So I thought of using all three of these houses. Then I made a beach with this brushed corduroy and mustard seed and combining those two colors. And then I go in with the Stormy Sky a bit to get some shading underneath the waves so you can see them better. And just a little black scribbled line around the sun. And then I was thinking on how to put the houses, and I thought, okay, I'm just going to do a half blue house on the one side, and then the other half I'm going to glue on the other side. Why not? Because I thought it was a shame to throw them away. Now, gluing down the shells here and there. It's quite a quick card to do because the coloring took some time, but the rest, no, I think 35 minutes in total. I have to admit, I made a gesso background first, but messed it up, so I had to make another one. But with this one, it took me 35 minutes, I think. Now, done that, what did I do next? I think I outlined the card. I'm not sure. Let's see what happens. Oh no, I got this Prima watercolor box, pencil box, w from a friend of mine, Cindy, and she gifted that to me just because she had double and she thought, oh, well, Rengi can use it. And I used the gray one to get a little bit of shading underneath the houses, and then I outlined it. Now, for the sentiment, I just used the name of the sheets, the stamp sheets, A Day at the Beach. I thought that was appropriate for these cards. So, the only thing I need to do is show you some pictures, and then I want to say thank you, and I'll see you next time on another video, and I will thank you for everyone who's commenting and leaving a thumbs up. It's really, really appreciated. And until the next time, bye.